this is going to be interesting.
Right, tank's full and we're heading off out of Gascoyne Junction. Been here for the last week due to the roads being closed as it's been very wet. But they opened up last night as far as the Kennedy Ranges National Park, which is about 60 kilometres from here, so we'll do that today. Beyond there to Mount Augustus, the roads are still closed, so we'll just wait and see what happens. Here's a map to show you where we are. Gascoyne Junction. And from there, we'll go to the mud puddle, where I'll dispel a few myths about the last video, and then proceed to Kennedy Ranges National Park, which is there. I've heard it's really good. And once the roads open, we'll head to Mount Augustus, which is the world's largest rock, and then from there a convoluted path all the way to Tom Price. But because it's so far, we'll stop at a wild camp along the way. Oh my goodness, what's that? That's one of Alex Green's satellite dishes that he uses on his picnic tables in Camomile. Okay, Gascoyne Junction's an interesting little town, I've found. It's got about 20 houses, got a council chamber, because it's the centre of the Upper Gascoyne district. And it's got a school, a K-12 school, and a TAFE with a total of 5 students. Now, not only that, it's got a pub and caravan park, and is famous for not only being the most non-religious place in Australia, but also mucolite, a agate-like stone, which is everywhere. Oh, I'm just waving to the guy that beat me in the pub last night at pool. He's a concreter and they're building an amphitheatre, a skate park and a information centre, I believe. Okay, we're about to head off around the corner here and head over the Gascoyne River, which famously in 2010 flooded and took out the pub and the service station, and they had to rebuild it in a different spot. Last week this bridge was underwater, apparently, according to the locals, quite a rare event. Normally a dry riverbed with isolated pools. Up here on the left is Kenny Kempton's house. Being in Gascoyne for a while, the locals said I should go and have a chat to Kenny Kempton. But unfortunately, he was out in the bush laying 2 ton of dingo bait, which in itself would have been a pretty interesting story. You may recognise this section of road from the video Tilapia, which was a half-hearted attempt by me at going tilapia fishing with a bucket after being inspired by Fred. back time again. The Kennedy Ranges, probably one of the most remarkable places I've visited on this trip. Basically, a lump of sandstone raised 100 metres from the surrounding plain. It's about 75 kilometres long and 25 kilometres wide, and topped with red sand dunes and spinifex grassland, which you can see on the left there. The edges are heavily eroded, forming stunning gorges, perfect for bushwalking. From the campground, there are various walks along the base of the cliffs, which lead into the deep, eroded gorges. Bushwalking was walking up to Escarpment Lookout, but instead of heading back from there, I navigated my way around to each of the promontories, negotiating a labyrinth of eroded gullies along the way. Off the main track, I came across this headland, which was about a metre wide and 20 metres long. Musar didn't have the nerve to walk out there because it's some 100 metres above the surrounding plain. Someone had, however, they'd built a cairn at the end. Absolutely stunning place. Space. Space. Space.
Space. Space. Space. Space.
Thank you.
As I ride away from Barangaram and look back at its form, I'm reminded of a Dreamtime story about Barangara, a boy who escaped tribal initiation but was speared, and as he crawled away, died. If you look at the outline of Barangara from this direction, you can see him lying face down. Sad story.
Thank you.